Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
In this video, we are going to define and find the acceleration of a freely falling object as a function of the gravitational acceleration. Calculate the acceleration of a freely falling stone. Specify the nature of the upward motion and the downward motion of the stone. Calculate the maximum height reached by the stone. Calculate the speed of the stone as it reaches the ground. And calculate the time of flight of the stone.
Let's study freely falling object. A freely falling object is any object moving freely under the action of its weight alone, regardless of its initial velocity. Let's determine the acceleration of this object. The system is the object. The external forces acting on this object is only its weight, which is directed vertically downwards. Now, apply Newton's second law. The sum of the external forces acting on this object equals the mass times the acceleration of the object. Replace the sum of the external forces by mg, so mg equals ma. Divide by m both sides, then the acceleration of a freely falling object equals g. Look at the figure. G is directed vertically downward. If y is directed positively upward, then relative to this y-axis, g equals minus gj. So relative to this axis, a equals minus gj. In general, in vacuum, all objects fall with the same acceleration regardless of their initial velocity. And this acceleration equals the gravitational acceleration g.
The two objects are dropped simultaneously. The mass of the apple is three times as that of the orange. Which one reaches the ground first? In this experiment, we neglect air resistance. We observe that the two objects reach the ground at the same time, since they have the same acceleration, which is equal to the gravitational acceleration.
Why do objects dropped in air from the same height reach the ground at the same time? The two objects reach the ground simultaneously if they travel the same distance during the same time. If we neglect air resistance, the acceleration of any object moving in air is equal to the gravitational acceleration, and this acceleration is constant. Then, the expression of the distance is given by 1/2 at squared plus v0t. Now, the two objects will travel the same distance during the same time if they have the same initial velocity and the same acceleration. And this is the case. The two objects are released from rest and they move with the same acceleration. Then they will reach the ground simultaneously. What do we conclude from this study? We conclude that if air resistance is neglected, the time of a flight of an object in air is independent of its mass. Now, let's solve an exercise about a freely falling object. Tom uses a pocket shot to shoot a stone as vertically upward. The stone is shot at time zero from a point O 6 meters above ground with an initial velocity of magnitude 4.9 meters per second. Extend the positive y-axis upward and take the launching point O as its origin. Number one, determine the value of the acceleration of S. Our system is the stone S. The external force acting on the stone is only the weight mg, which is directed vertically downwards. Now let's use Newton's second law. So mg equals ma, the m's cancel out, then a equals g. Now look at the figure. The gravitational acceleration is directed vertically downwards, and the positive y direction is vertical upward. Then a equals minus gj. Replace g by 9.8. Then a equals minus 9.8j. Therefore, the value of the acceleration of the stone is minus 9.8 meters per second squared.
Number 2. Deduce the nature of the upward motion and the downward motion of S. We proved in the previous slide that the acceleration is constant and negative during the whole motion of S. We know that in rectilinear motion with constant acceleration, if A times V is greater than 0, then the motion is uniformly accelerated rectilinear. And if A times V is less than 0, then the motion is uniformly decelerated rectilinear. Let's study the upward motion of S. During the upward motion of S, the stone moves along the positive y direction, so V is positive, and A is negative, therefore A times V is less than 0. Therefore, during the upward motion of S, this motion is uniformly decelerated rectilinear. Now, let's study the downward motion of S. During the downward motion of S, the stone moves in a direction opposite to the positive y direction. Therefore, now V is negative. And A is negative, therefore A times V is positive. Therefore, the motion of S is uniformly accelerated rectilinear.
Focus, please. This is important.
Let's move to part 3. Calculate the time needed by S to reach the maximum height. First, let me remind you with the three basic equations of rectilinear motion with constant acceleration. Now, which equation would we choose? The value of the velocity at the maximum height is 0, and we want to calculate the time needed to reach the maximum height. Then, let's use the first equation. Replace V by 0, A by minus 9.8 meters per second squared, V0 by 4.9 meters per second. Then, the time needed by S to reach the maximum height is 0.5 seconds.
Number 4. Deduce relative to the ground the maximum height reached by the stone. Now, we have to use the second equation. Y represents the ordinate of the stone relative to the origin O. So, y equals 1/2 at squared plus v0t plus y0. But the stone starts from the origin O, so y0 equals 0. Now, replace each physical quantity by its value. A equals minus 9.8. At the maximum height, t equals 0.5 seconds. And V0, or the starting velocity, equals 4.9. Therefore, the ordinate, or the maximum ordinate, of this stone relative to the origin O equals 1.2 meters. But the maximum height reached by this stone relative to the ground is given by Y maximum plus OB, where OB is the distance between O and the ground. Therefore, H maximum equals 8.2 meters.
Let's move to part 5. Calculate the speed of S as it reaches the ground. Because we don't have the time of the flight, so we can't use the first two equations, we will use the third equation. But how can we calculate delta y? Delta y equals the final ordinate minus the initial ordinate. The final ordinate is yb. Look at point B. Point B is 6 meters below the origin of the y-axis, and the y-axis extends positively upwards. Then yb equals minus 6, while yo equals 0, because the stone is launched at time 0 from point O, which is the origin of the y-axis. Then we have minus 6 minus 0, which is equal to minus 6 meters. Now we are ready to calculate the speed at point B. The initial speed is 4.9 meters per second. The acceleration is minus 9.8 meters per second squared, and delta y equals minus 6 meters. Then Vb equals minus 11.9 meters per second. Vb is negative because in the way back, the stone is moving in the negative y direction. The speed of the stone as it reaches the ground is 11.9 meters per second.
Number 6. Calculate the time of flight of the stone, or the time needed by the stone to reach the ground at point B. During the whole motion of the stone, we know its acceleration, and we know the initial velocity, and we know the velocity of the stone as it reaches the ground. So we have to use the first equation, which is V equals AT plus V0. Now replace each physical quantity by its value. At the ground, the velocity equals minus 11.9, A equals minus 9.8 during the whole motion of the stone, and the initial velocity equals 4.9. Then the time needed by the stone to reach the ground, T equals 1.7 seconds.
Let's find the time of a flight by another method. We will use the second equation. Replace YB by minus 6, A by minus 9.8, V0 by 4.9, and Y0 by 0. You will get this quadratic equation. Using the calculator gives two answers. The first answer is positive. It is the time of a flight. The second answer is negative, so it is rejected.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.